wisdom is bliss. Four friendly fun facts that can change your life. By Robert Thurman. Dedication. To my mothers, who bravely create the miracle of life and caringly enable its infinite livability. To my fathers who madly love them and stand diamond true in joyous awe. To my lamas, the soul friends, who open the door to the clear light reality of blissful freedom and compassionate love. And to all my children, every kind and hue, the long now many coming generations on this magnificent planetary Buddhaverse. This audiobook includes a supplemental PDF that contains an illustration, tables, a list of titles for further reading, the acknowledgments, and the About the Author section from the print edition. I will be referring to the PDF throughout the recording, so be sure to have it handy as you listen. It should be among the files you downloaded when you purchased this audiobook. May all the travelers upon the road find real happiness where'er they go, and gain without needing too much struggle the highest goals which will fulfill their hearts. All of these practices were taught by the Buddha for the sake of wisdom. Thus those who wish to free themselves from suffering must cultivate this wisdom. Shantideva, 8th century. Don't try to use whatever you learn from Buddhism to be a Buddhist. Use it to be a better whatever you already are. His Holiness the Dalai Lama. Preface. I love the Buddha, I really do. But I'm not promoting the religion of Buddhism for anyone. I love just as much Ms. Buddha, the Vajrayogini, Her Holiness the Shekhinah, the Great Mother, the Blessed Moses, Holy Mary and Sweet Jesus, brave Khadija and the Holy Muhammad, wise Lao Tzu, insightful Confucius, Radha and Krishna, Uma and Shiva, White Buffalo Woman, Wakan Tanka, Quetzalcoatl, Chalchut Likui, countless shamanic teachers of indigenous peoples, and every single wise and loving grandmother, so many holy teachers, gods, and saints. They all perform such wonders and benefit so many, opening all kinds of amazing doors for all kinds of beautiful people, each to discover their own divine qualities, their wise intelligence, and loving heart. I do mention my beloved Shakyamuni Buddha more often, since I meet him more and more as I learn, discovering how helpful he has been to me as a super scientist, a super educator, and a cool global social revolutionary, but not so much as a spiritual person doing the great work of a religious prophet or a religion organizer. I follow His Holiness the Dalai Lama's sincere policy and prime directive not to missionize or convert anyone from or to any religion or secular belief system. In fact, it is quite natural to stick to that policy, since the Buddha himself rebelled against the religions of his own time and rather set out to understand, rationally and experientially, the nature of reality. The historical Buddha was a rigorous scientist in the modern sense, that is, an explorer of reality. I also unequivocally declare that he is the scientist who successfully, accurately, and comprehensively discovered the real reality, the miracle of bliss-void indivisible freedom. Yet, for the sake of all the others, did not ignore the less real realities. Buddha was also an educator, so I tried to learn and teach his curriculum, designed to enable any serious student of whatever faith or doubt to achieve reliable, lasting happiness. I have spent 5 decades doing university teaching about Buddhism, somewhat mischaracterized as a, quote, world religion, unquote, since flat earth modern Euro-American philosophy departments have not yet discovered the Pacific Ocean of world-class Buddhist and non-Buddhist critical philosophies. In this book, I intend to teach the real thing, a Buddha's threefold super-education, which is divided into eight branches. Buddha had to be an educator rather than a prophet or religion founder, since he had achieved his goal of an exact and complete understanding of reality by using reason, experiments to open his own mind, and death-transcending vision. He realized that since he, once a pampered yuppie prince, had been able to do it, other human beings also could do it. From his own experience, he could help them as a teacher by streamlining the process. He could not just transplant his realization into their minds. They could not get their own realizations just by believing whatever he said. He could only provide them with a prospect of full realization along a path of learning and experiencing they could follow. They would have to travel on their own. But we should never be discouraged. Let's remember that he himself and all those who succeeded with his teachings over the millennia were originally just like you and me. It is important to realize that the Buddha was not teaching Buddhists, as there weren't any then. He taught all kinds of people who had grown up devoted to Vedist gods, Brahmin priests, and texts quite able to satisfy both mundane and spiritual concerns. Yet many of those same people were inspired by the Buddha's example and quickly found his teachings useful in their living practice. Many men and women were moved to enroll full-time for his triple super education, ethical, mental, and scientific, and they dropped out of their various life professions and became mendicant seekers, fortunately enabled to do so by the wealth and generosity of their societies. They were supported with free lunch scholarships by generous lay sponsors, kings and common.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.